It is, but it could be a lot worse here, solo travelers. You know, remember the old song here? Cold November rain? Could be that. At least it's kind of a warmer rain. WDSU First Warning Weather Doppler radar. Let's show you where it's raining, and it is as far north as New Orleans right now and all the way to the South Shore and the coast. But that's about it. North Shore, you haven't gotten hardly anything at all so far. You've only gotten just, well, cloud cover. Here it is. We go right into the city where we've got some of the steady rain that's there and light rain. It's maybe steady as you head to the radar in Chalmette. We've got maybe some heavier pockets of rain going out St. Bernard Parish, Hopedale. We've got some of the heavier rain. Delacroix, just light rain. Kenilworth, the Reggio, though, as we go to pockets of moderate rain. It's light in lower Plaquemines, the Empire to Venice and Burris. We got Grand Isle with steady rain, Golden Meadow and Cutoff. And we also have Raceland, Lockport, Houma, Bayou Cane, and Thibodeau. That's going to be a pocket of some steady rain right here. Can't forget about Morgan City to our friends and neighbors just west of us. And even to the River Parishes, light rain has moved to you. So the I-10 corridor, but you go to I-12 north, really nothing going on there. So that's the rain, and it's just kind of shower activity lining up with this forecast really, really well. As we put it in motion, it will continue to fade after sunset. And then we get a break until we get the next round tomorrow. Tomorrow morning. Now, this is connected to the tropics. Now, I'm not expecting any tropical activity. Even what I'll show you here, I'm still not expecting any development that will affect us down the road. But the National Hurricane Center still says this area in the Gulf a 30% chance, maybe down the road, of development. Again, that's past 2 days from now. We can see one system, the rain that's already in the Gulf, and then this impressive system that was once a tropical depression. And now forecast data really starting to pick up on the leftovers from that storm moving into the Gulf as well. That could be the big player over the next 7 days, but we've got fronts already on us, and that's going to push everything just away from us. So this is a problem for a lot of the platforms and a lot of the boating and then ship traffic that would be going on in the Gulf and Florida. And it's all due to that leftover system once was a tropical depression. But look at this particular forecast. It outlines the energy well, puts it into the Gulf right here. So what we're looking at is humidity, but I'm able to tell that spin and show you much easier. The first leading spin fades away, but look at this one take over by the latest forecast. Really get some action going as we go middle of next week. And then into Tampa, that is not good news. Tampa really got hit hard by storm surge, even though Helene just flanked them. A lot of storm activity and rain still into the Gulf. We're right on the edge here, but there is a recent forecast to take a little bit more rain closer to New Orleans. So that does mean some areas, the Jean Lafitte, Belle Chasse, might have some more rain over the next 3 to 4 days. So the takeaways for us, rain today and tomorrow, then the rain chances still go down over the weekend. Still the north is not looking for a whole lot of rain, but most of it falling on the coast. Late next week, we'll need to monitor for what I just showed, the potential that we get a storm that goes to Florida. Real-time temps, some 70s where the rain's been here, 80s. We've really kind of put more humidity in the atmosphere from that rain. Just to confirm, the rain goes away by tomorrow morning. Look at it redevelop. This might mean that the morning drive could be a wet one. It might be a few minutes to check in with Raven Richard in the morning. And then as we head through Friday morning to midday, it's still raining. Once we get to the afternoon, the rain's starting to wind down. So this is showing to me that the temperatures will be held down with the cloud cover, but opening gates for Gretna Fest, the rain chances starting to decrease, and it's just leftover clouds. Temps are still pretty nice. We head into Saturday, the rain mainly stays south, and we're still looking good for Fried Chicken Fest, Gretna Fest. We even have Cape Paso going on here too. So a lot of events going on this weekend. Saturday and Sunday should be really good days. The only chance of some lingering showers might be Friday evening, but it's winding down. So overall, the main rain event is now through tomorrow morning, and it could be the morning commute is the one to get through.